I'm not going to jump over.
No, she weighs in.
Thank you all. Monty. Are there folks in there that would like to come in here now?
I can see.
I don't know how many are left in there. Steve, how many people are in there?
Yeah, they should be able to get in there.
I don't know if we get them all.
Yeah.
Well, maybe so. Thank you, Monty.
Don't get that too close.
Okay, let's continue.
They're still 2 seconds.
Item 7 is the approval of grant funds. We'll call and welcome Kathy Holland, Director of Alamance County Board of Elections. Kathy, good evening.
Good evening, gentlemen. My presentation is short and sweet. I have $13,519.42 in grant funds. Just asking that you accept them. You have
so
a.
We have a motion.
Second.
Any questions for Kathy? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Thank you,
Kathy.
I'm glad you brought your dad to drug you tonight, Kathy.
We should have had you before the break. You'd gone home. Okay. Now we will move to the presentation of the manager's recommended budget for fiscal year 13-14. Greg, good evening, sir.
Good evening. And again, let me first start off by saying this is the manager's recommended budget. And again, this may be changed by the Board of Commissioners at any time. Any additional information that you may need as a result of this or any additional workshops you want from this, please let me know. We'll be more than happy to do what we can. Again, this is the recommended. But again, the final budget and final decision is the Board of Commissioners. So we'll go ahead and start.
Craig, are we going to get ours or do we get it later?
Ms. Weaver has your budget.
Thank you.
Budget retreat. This is a quick reminder from our budget retreat where we really started from. This was on April 15th. Revenues was $123.3 million projection. Expenditures that was requested.
Yeah, press. You did one after.
Yeah. You can get it after, Thomas.
Here we go.
Okay. Always like to make Thomas wait. but again, the revenues projected were $123.3. Expenditures requested from all departments was $131.9 million. And again, we had a difference there of $8.5 million that we were in the red. Managers recommended, and again, this is general fund, will be $127.8 million. How do we get there? We're recommending a tax increase in the managers recommended of 3.5 cents.
I'm sorry, I should have offered the preamble to this is we're here in Mr. Honeycutt's comments and recommended budget. And we will then have, as many of you know, a public hearing on this budget at our next meeting, which will be June the 3rd at Williams High School
right.
at 7 o'clock
yes,
in the evening.
Sir.
So what we're here now is we're receiving information. No action is to be taken tonight pending the public hearing at our next meeting. I'm sorry, Greg. Go ahead.
Okay. Thank you. Again, we're looking, the manager's recommended is taking our tax rate from 52 cents to 55 and a half cents per 100 valuation. It's a 3.5 cent increase. And again, one penny on the tax rate equals about $1.2 million. The tax rate will help fund. And again, there's a lot of things that we have not funded in the past 4 years. Employee raises, this is general fund, at a 5% across the board will be $1.7 million. And that includes benefits as well. Again, one of the issues that this board has been faced with is our dwindling fund balance. We'd like to recommend that we put almost $1.6 million into fund balance. We're also would like recommend increases for the school system and also for the community college, a total of $1.6 million. It's $1.5 for ABSS and about $100,000 for the schools or for the community college. We do have some capital needs that we've not funded. About $260,000 of that is for EMS. We have a roof at Eli Whitney that is like a colander right now that needs to be replaced. So we have money set aside for roof repair. We're recommending to transfer to County Buildings Capital Reserve Fund $300,000. We still have projects that we need to do as far as facilities. We have chiller projects. We have just basic maintenance projects and larger issues that our normal maintenance budget just cannot completely absorb. The reason why we're looking at this is so we don't have to borrow $9.2 million in another 10 years to fund facilities. So if we can start putting some money aside, beginning addressing facilities now and put money into that fund, it'll give us some flexibility. Transfer to revaluation fund. As Mr. Bell mentioned earlier, revaluation's coming up. We need to begin building up the revaluation fund. Again, in the fixed cost increase is $1.43 million. This is a cost we talked about at the retreat from insurance, retirement, and also from unemployment. These are mandatory costs of a $1.43 million increase.
Craig, may I ask, you say the increase ABSS and ACC 1.6
total.
Is that right?
Total, 1.6.
How much for each?
1.5 for the school system and 100,000 for ACC. But again, if you look at the total cost on that, it's about $7 million if my math is right. And again, the tax increase would generate $4.2 million.
What I thought at one time you'd said we might have to allocate more for debt service. Is that not the case?
Debt service went up a little bit this year, or did it go down a
it
little bit?
It went up a little bit in the current year,
right.
In, but it's actually going down a little bit for next fiscal
right.
year due to the refunding.
Right. So, but again, these are areas that we've not been able to fund or address in the last 4 years. And again, this is a fixed cost increase. As I mentioned, our employee health insurance would go up almost over $500,000. Unemployment insurance from the state, which is mandatory, is $56,000. Unemployment insurance reserve, that is also now mandatory by the state, is $300,000. There's an increase for our state retirement employer contribution, $122,000. And again, an increase for our health insurance retiree, and that also includes the mental health that we have picked up. So that's $1.43 million. Personnel. We're recommending right now to look at one new position. And one position we're looking at would be in our fire marshal's office. We don't have a safety officer in the county. We had an OSHA visit the other day, and luckily it went well, but we need to begin looking at having a safety director and a risk manager within the county. And for a county this size, it's one of those almost a mandatory thing. But that's the only new position we are looking at. We are looking at some reclassifications, and again, as Mr. Bell mentioned about looking at appraisers, we had a couple of frozen positions within the tax department that we would reclassify and change them to residential appraiser and also a farm appraiser. So again, those were part of the budget. And those are just reclassified. They were part of this year's budget of positions that weren't filled. The SARA management, that is money that we get paid by the industries to manage chemicals. We would change that position from an office assistant 3 to an EM, a Sarah Planner. And again, that's no direct general fund cost to the county. They would be paid with the Sarah funds. And again, another dental clinic position, we would reclassify, but again, that's no county funds as well as dental clinic is fully self-funded. Any questions on that? One of the things that we did is we've had some open positions within our budget. You know, we made some cuts as well. We have cut out 20 positions from this year's budget going into next year's. In the health department, we cut three full-time positions, or really four. Inspections, we cut two chief inspector positions that had been frozen. The jail, we cut a detention officer, and also we made changes to how we do help at the jail, and appreciate the sheriff and Tim Britt working on making those changes. Basically, we're changing it to a contracted service instead of doing it in-house. So we were able to eliminate those positions. Again, in the sheriff's department, we were able to eliminate five positions. Again, talking about employee raises, last employee raise for all employees was July 1, 2008. And again, that would be 5 years as of this year. So the recommendation would be is a 5% cost of living for all employees, general fund, which will cost us $1.7 million, and our landfill, it will cost us $42,403. One of the things that we talked about at the retreat was an additional look at retention for law enforcement, especially for our sworn officers in the jail and also our sworn road officers. And looking at turnover, which is a big issue with the sheriff, and looking at salaries of municipalities in the county and also some adjacent counties as well, we would recommend another 4% be added on top of the 5% for the sworn law enforcement. So the non-sworn law enforcement positions within the sheriff's department would only get 5%. The sworn officers would get 9%. Capital needs. Again, budget retreat. We came in at capital needs. The request was for $3.4 million. A recommendation that we have is for $328,700. Again, that's two ambulances and equipment for EMS at $265,000. And again, recreation, $63,700 for some additional lawn equipment and also the roof replacement at Eli Whitney.
How many ambulances did he buy this fiscal year?
Four, and there's also some service trucks as well, first responder vehicles.
More than $1 million. $1 million were put out.
Yes, sir. We put $1 million in capital that we borrowed for this year, or was in this year's budget. Yes, right, sir.
And Eli Whitney, I thought we repaired that roof.
I thought we did too.
The two flat portions.
Yeah.
We did not replace
the round.
The two flats were leaking at the time, and they both got replaced, and that was about 35.
You mean the barrel over the court?
Yeah.
Yes. The main roof over the main part of the court, that's what's to be replaced this time.
I thought that's what we did last time.
Yeah. It was the flat roof over the office area.
Because when we went out there and looked at it, we didn't look at the flat area. We looked at the court. We were talking about the barrel. We talked about totally about the barrel.
We tried to do some repair and, you know, some minor patchwork repair, and it just needs to be replaced.
Did we spend $50,000 out there?
No.
Not on the roofs.
Did you fix the bathrooms down below, too?
No. We replaced the heat system there. We did major work on the floor. Replaced the two flat roofs, which I think the roofs were about $30,000.
And the heat system.
I think we were close to $100,000 investment total in the building at that time. We patched the barrel roof three to four times.
Is it still leaking?
Yes. We're closing regularly when it rains.
Are those two bathrooms downstairs fixed?
No, no. No, we've closed off the two
totally
locker rooms, yes.
Again, transfer to other funds. Again, looking at putting an additional $200,000 into the revaluation fund. But again, also putting $300,000 to our capital reserve fund. And again, this is the fund we use like when we had the fire alarm issue. You know, we had the $75,000. We did not have to go to our fund balance to get the money out of. You know, we had money set aside to do those major capital projects. And it made it much easier than just trying to get a fund balance and to hit fund balance and to where we don't need to be hitting fund balance. But again, this will be used just like we do it now. Anything over, what's the amount, 10?
$10,000
as far as that would come out of that capital reserve fund would have to be approved by the Board of Commissioners. And again, fund balance issues. This has been a big issue. You know, we had the letter from the LGC asking what we're going to do with our fund balance. We're not using any fund balance again to balance off this year's budget for the second year in a row. But again, this will be allocating directly back to our fund balance almost $1.6 million.
Are we finishing with 8 or above?
Yes, sir. That is a projection right now, is that we will definitely finish in the black.
8 or above percent?
Yeah, right. He's talking about the required percent.
We believe so, yes, sir.
9.5 or 10.
We believe so, yes, sir.
You got to do it.
We're doing everything we can. We are doing everything that we can.
We told you a quarter ago, no offense.
We
had to do it.
Well, we did. We've made some strong cuts. We've frozen additional positions.
What percentage of how low did we get at the end of
the year? Well, the state last year, we were at
7.83.
So.
How many inspectors do we have as a county? Home builders.
I off the top of my head, I can't.
We got too many.
Well, we have eliminated.
This has been going on too long, and you need to get a backbone and start replacing people who this county doesn't need. You need to do things that you're not doing. You are not doing a manager's job, in my opinion, and you need to start growing a backbone and standing up to your employees. That's what I see, and I've been seeing it since I came on this board, and I'm tired of seeing it. I want you to do your job.
Outside agency funding. No additional funding for outside agencies except ABSS, ACC, and also we're looking at increasing Alamance Rescue. ABSS funding, looking at additional $1.5 million, which a total for that would be $32.655 million. And again, that's $2.6 million less than requested. And again, we have decreased funding from ABS since 2011-12 by $2.345 million. Current expense, we would recommend looking at $1.25 million. And capital outlay would be $250,000, which we have not funded capital in the last couple of years. And why the increase is recommended, again, you know, I think there's a huge issue with this board about their large fund balance. And their large fund balance did get up above $21 million. But now it is projected to be $5.9 million by June 30th. And also, even with the cuts from 2011, they've increased their ADM numbers by over 300 students. Again, ACC funding is a 4.6% increase over the 12-13 fiscal year. Current expense, $2.7 million. Capital outlay, $240,000. With a total allocation of $2.9 million. And again, Alamance County Rescue Squad. Currently, we have allocated approximately $50,000. It's the recommendation that we go to $100,000. And the reasoning why is they currently offer services to the they man the station 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, for 6 hours. The additional funding of $50,000 would allow hiring of a part-time instead of 6 hours a day, 5 days, 8 hours a day, 7 days a week. And also, working with them, they would set aside $20,000 of that new funding to be set aside for capital reserve. Emergency telephone fund is proposed budget was 1.071 million, and the 2012-13 budget is 670,000. Again, we have some increased equipment purchases, but again, most of that does come from the 911 funds. And again, our landfill fund proposed budget of 3.1 million, which is about $310,000 less than this year's. Again, not purchasing as much capital this year, but again, no fee increases recommended either.
That doesn't affect the budget anyway, does
it? No, sorry, it's part of the total budget, but not the general fund budget. And again, as we talked about at the retreat, the rural fire departments, we have three that have requested tax increase: EM Holt, Northeastern Alamance, and Snow Camp. And that is their request. And if you remember, we had their presentation as well. Again, this is our budget schedule, public hearing, June 3rd, 2013 at 7 p.m. at Williams. And if the board wouldn't mind, I'd like to kind of read the conclusion I put in the back of your budget. Tax increases are never popular. However, if you look at the issues that the county has dealt with the past 4 years, they're sometimes necessary to ensure that we maintain an adequate fund balance, a good workforce, funding for basic public safety needs, facilities, schools, and being proactive with some of our building maintenance. We have continually cut expenses, but now we're at a point where we must be proactive as we move forward. We believe that this is a good budget, as it begins funding many different county functions that must be addressed. No one is getting all they wanted, but we have taken the approach we must start addressing many different areas that have not been funded in recent years. As the old proverb states, how do you eat an elephant? And the answer being one bite at a time. We believe this budget is a budget that takes multiple small bites out of the elephant as we move forward. I would like to thank the work of our department heads in helping formulating this budget, especially our finance department, Finance Director Amy Weaver, Susan Roberts, and Brenda Murphy, for all the work that's been done to come to this recommended budget. Again, this is a manager's recommended budget, and if it does not reflect the wishes of the Board of County Commissioners, then we are willing to work to make sure that the wishes of the board are followed. We continually strive to make sure that we provide the highest level of services to our citizens, and I appreciate the opportunity to serve you, the community, and the best county staff anywhere as your county manager. We present this budget for your consideration.
At the end of this fiscal year, 12-13, this is how many fiscal years since reevaluation up here at the courthouse when we set the rate at 52? Just
four? 2008.
All right. What I'd like to ask you to do is to give us a total, give us 4 years of revenues at all levels that have come in, you know, increases, decreases, so we can compare what at the end of this fiscal year, what the revenues are, and all sales taxes, right, property taxes, fees, everything that we're getting at the end of this year, fiscal year, that we, what it was up here at the courthouse, right, that night. 4 years comparison, if you don't mind.
Yes, sir.
I'm pleased with most of the budget here, but the sheriff and patrol vehicles, is there anything in the budget for any automobiles for him?
We've talked about it. I think the sheriff is okay for this year. However, next year would be a different story. You know, it would also help if we could get the Department of Justice to release our drug forfeiture funds.
Oh, I know. I understand that. Yeah. But we can't depend on that. Yeah. And we can't depend on drug forfeiture money coming in the future right. either. Is that right, Sheriff?
That's correct. They've frozen it right now.
How many cars have you received in the last 4 years from the county?
Four, I think, total of four.
And those were not patrol cars, right?
Yeah, we received four patrol cars in the last 4 or 5 years.
Yeah. And
so what's the mileage running on your vehicles now, these patrol cars?
We've got some well over 150,000, 140,000.
We have bought cars, but most of the cars that have been purchased have been with drug forfeiture.
Yeah.
But as far as general fund, I believe we've purchased four.
And what? How many patrol cars do you have out 24/7?
All patrol cars.
I know. What number? What's the number?
We have about 140 total cars, that's detectives and everything. But our patrol division, we have 10 on shift, and yes, 10 cars per shift, 4 shifts. That's 40 cars is constantly, got the high mileage on.
Yeah. Amy, does the health department still have this $700,000 or $800,000 in a slush fund?
Yes, sir.
Why can't we use some of that money to buy some cars for the, I mean, these guys are out there 24/7 and they're in high speed chases, and I think one wrecked not long ago, didn't it? Tire blew out on it?
We'll be more than glad to work with the sheriff's department and come up with a number for that.
Thank you.
Craig, we talked a lot in the fall about funds for economic development, for infrastructure. That was part of the package that was not approved by the voters. And you don't have anything in here for that. And, you know, Mac always reminds us that, you know, we're low on that scale, too. Is there any consideration, or can we at least look at a scenario? And I don't even know specifically what they would be used for, but can we just talk to Mac and maybe see if there's something that would help? And I'm not talking about funds that he can use to join another association. I'm talking about funds that we can use to continue
that there's
the work.
A direct benefit from those funds expenditure. And I think there is at this point, I don't know of what it would be, but would be, you know, there would be money set aside also in our contingency. You know, we have a contingency this year. We also will have a contingency in next year's budget as well. So if we did want to do something with economic development, you know, to not a grand expense, you know, we could look at using some of that, but as long as we came up with the outcomes that we wanted to accomplish. So be glad.
Well, I'd just like to consider it when, you know, as we go toward the hearing. I don't know exactly what it should look like, but I know that we are, what's he say, 19th out of 20th in terms of commitment to economic development resources?
Out of the 20 counties.
In our peer counties. So can we just look at a possible scenario?
Yeah. We will look at what type of outcomes we're trying to obtain with economic development. And again, probably don't have the funding for direct infrastructure, but if there's some marketing or if there's some, you know, specific things that we want to try to do, we'll see if we can come up with something.
I'm not saying I agree with all of your budget, but I think you and your staff have done a real good job.
Thank you.
We have a lot of problems and needs, but y'all covered a lot of them.
Other comments or questions for Mr. Honeycutt? What it sounds like we need to do is each of us need to take this and review it and look at the numbers and get back with you and or Amy to answer any questions that we may have. Public hearing on June 3rd will happen. We may vote on the budget that night, but we don't have to. Is that right? We have to vote on it by June, whatever the second meeting is.
June 30th or continuation.
Any other questions for Craig at this time?
Okay. Thank you very much. Resolution to sell property located at 706 West Haggard Avenue. Mr. Albright, good evening, sir.
Hello, hello. This property at 706 West Haggard Avenue was acquired by the county through a federal development grant. One of these programs where the federal government gives money to the state. The state gives it to the county. The county finds a property that it thinks it can rehab. And unfortunately, in this case, the property was not rehabilitatable. And so the house has been demolished, and the county needs to sell this property and return the money back to the federal government. And the break-even on this is $62,000. What I've proposed is a negotiated offer and upset bid. We have an offer from Elon University for $62,000 under the state statute. If the board chooses to go this route, we'll describe the property to be sold in a notice to be placed in the newspaper, and the 10-day upset bid period will begin to run. And anybody can upset the bid by not less than 10% of the first $1,000 and 5% of the remainder. And then when the bid is raised, if it is raised, another 10-day period begins until nobody's upset anymore and we have a final figure. But we do have an offer from Elon University for $62,000 for the property, which will break even on this grant, our demolition cost, and get this property back in the hands of the university and the cash back in the hands of the federal taxpayers.
So this is Mooney Lawn? The property is Mooney Lawn? I thought Elon already owned that.
Pardon me?
It says it's Mooney Lawn Park. Have you seen the property?
Yes, yes.
Is it the Mooney Lawn Park?
I'm not sure.
So it's next to that?
It's right next to it, I guess.
Okay.
It was a hovel.
It was a what?
The rats had moved out. It was terrible.
All right. David made a motion. David, I'm sorry. Is there a second?
Second that motion.
Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you, Clyde. And now we'll go to the county manager's report, which includes a couple of budget amendment discussions, I believe.
It does. Thanks, Mr. Chairman. First, there's a packet of information that you have in front of you. There are two applications that we would submit to the North Carolina Education Lottery Fund. One is for $467,193.94. That is the debt service for the Career Tech Center that we would get reimbursement from. And the other is for $1,424,873.63. That is to cover the debt service, and that is Article 43 that's supposed to be covering debt service from the sales tax, that's supposed to cover debt service for schools, which is short, and we can apply to the lottery funds for the reimbursement.
Is there a motion to accept the lottery money for the aforementioned purposes?
Is that for the schools?
Well, it would come back to us.
Oh, okay. So moved.
Second?
Second.
Any other discussion or questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Craig, you got another one?
I do. In front of you, you have budget number 94, 95, 96, 97, and 98. And basically, this is at the request of our auditors. We had some small capital project budgets that are still been outstanding for many years. They've asked that we close this out, and any of the additional revenue would go into a capital facilities fund. But this is just really an auditing adjustment, closing out these projects.
Is there a motion for approval? Thank you, Tim. Is there a second? Dave, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Craig?
And that's all I have.
Okay, we covered grant from Board of Elections, so, okay. Commissioner comments. Do we have any more comments from the commissioners?
Well, I might as well. Is it okay? Anybody else got anything? All right. What I want to do is tell y'all a little bit about this piece of steel right here. I have a little buddy of mine, Caleb Lee Sutton, and he and I bum around the state every now and then. And back in April, Caleb and I were down at Fort Bragg, and I took a picture of Caleb. You can't see it, but he's standing by this piece of steel from World Trade Center. It's about three times taller than he is. It's unbelievable. And frankly, if I hadn't taken that picture of him that day and we hadn't seen this there that day, this would have never happened, I don't think. Because here, this is what happened. I was over in Greensboro last week. Well, I'm over there every day, but last week I saw a guy that I know, and we were shooting bull, and a bunch of us were talking, and I pulled out this picture. And I showed him a picture of Caleb and a bunch of stuff we do. And I casually made a reference that I sure would like to get a piece of that for Alamance County. And so the guy that I was talking to, he asked me not to say much about who he was or who they were, but he told me, he said that D.H. Griffith in Greensboro had a warehouse with a lot of this stuff in it. And boy, my ears perked up, because I knew we were getting ready to cut them a check, supposedly. They were doing work for us, and I thought, you know, we ought to, you know, hold a little powwow with them and tell them that we'd like to have a piece of that, and or a piece of it. I was thinking we might get a long piece like I'm looking at here. And so I called Craig and told Craig to get on it, if he would, and he got Brian and who else?
Richard
Hill to contact them, and this is the result of that. And the letter that they sent back, is okay if I read this?
Yes, sir.
It's on their letterhead, and it says, Certificate of Authenticity, piece of steel from the World Trade Center Tower 2. It said, D.H. Griffith Wrecking Company acknowledges its donation of this piece of the World Trade Center Tower 2 steel to Alamance County, North Carolina. This piece of steel, approximately 4 inches by 4 inches, was cut out of one of the core beams of Tower 2. This steel was some of the heaviest steel ever used in an office building anywhere in the world. D.H. Griffin served as the demolition consultant for the City of New York in charge of the World Trade Center 9/11 demolition project. And he, David Griffith, Jr., president of the company, signed the letter. And you called me and told me that it was there and that we were going to be able to get a piece. And that's the heaviest sucker I have ever, I mean, it is hard to hold up.
You wouldn't want to swim a river with that, would you?
No. I know somebody might want to tie it to, but I'll see if it's necessary after the meeting. But, I laughed about it. Come on. But this is really, frankly, I like it almost better than the big piece. The big piece, you would have had to have had an outside deal with it. This here is a different, I've never seen a cut like that, and it is different than it's my belief that what I'm looking at here were probably top pieces of metal still used, and so, this is so blasted heavy, I don't know where it came. Somebody mentioned that it was probably one of the lower foundation type pieces of steel. So I like it, and I, you know, obviously it's the county's, I believe, and I like to turn it over to the board and y'all to do with it as you wish. But I hope it's here to be looked at as a memory, a bad memory, a symbolic scenario to where we never forget what took place. And it's, I hope we can put it to good use somewhere, somehow.
Maybe staff can find some kind of glass case to put it in down in the lobby.
Well, we've either thought about, or maybe the Children's Museum, if that would be, make it as a donation from the County Board of Commissioners to the Children's Museum, if that is so, your wish.
Well, Tim, that's very nice, and if y'all haven't stepped up here and tried to pick it up, do that after the meeting. It is, it's a lot heavier than it looks.
Yeah.
Well, why don't, Greg, why don't you get with Tim and look at some different alternatives for placement and let us know what you decide?
I don't have a concern. This is ours, and y'all's, and our county's, I'm not gonna push it any further than say, there it is, just do something with it good, and hopefully it'll be around forever.
If that's okay, that would probably be the first option, would be to look at the Children's Museum and have a clawback in case something ever happened, that they would donate it back to the county if they ever went out of business. But it would have, we talked about maybe having a plaque that they would put up there, you know, as a donation from the Board of Commissioners.
Or you could loan it to them.
Very good, very nice. Any other comments or announcements? Greg, do we have any announcements?
No, sir.
Okay. There's nothing else to come before the board. Stand adjourned. Thank y'all for being here.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says Alamance County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.